What's going on, everybody? It's Dilmer, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm really excited to show you how we can set up MRTK to work with the Passthrough API. This is going to be really cool because not only we can use MRTK for the HoloLens 1 or HoloLens 2 devices, but we can also use it for the Oculus Quest 2. We're going to be able to basically do a pass-through, which we're going to be able to see to the real world from the Oculus Quest 2, but at the same time by using some of the really rich features that MRTK toolset provides. So let's jump into Unity and start working on it. All right, guys, so the first thing that I want you to look at is make sure that you have Unity 2019.4.3.4.F1. Honestly, any version of Unity 2019 will work for what I'm about to show you. And then the next thing that I'll do is go to File, Build Settings, and make sure that you change it to Android because we're going to be supporting the Oculus Passthrough, so it's going to be using Android. Now go into player settings. We're going to be focusing on the player for quite a bit. So if you go and look at Android, we're going to be changing this from gamma to linear. I also had issues running on Vulkan, so I'm going to go ahead and remove it and then use OpenGL ES3. Now if you scroll down, we're also going to be changing a couple of things in here. The API level, we're going to be doing API level 23. We can leave the target API as what it is. Also IL2 CPP because we're going to be supporting pass-through, and I'm also going to be doing .NET for .X. If you go down, let's go ahead and uncheck ARM v7. We're going to be using ARM 64, and then normally the next thing that I do is I also install the XR plugin management, so let's go ahead and install that. Okay, so once you have it installed, we're also going to be using the Oculus plugin provider, and then I would do also the same thing on desktop so that we can run the Oculus implementation by using our desktop. We can just go ahead and enable that. Now that you have that installed, the next thing that I recommend that you do is download the Mixed Reality feature tool, which I'm going to be putting the link in the description of this video so you guys can also download it. And then go into Start. If you go and select the project path, it's going to require that you have the project created, you know, beforehand, because then it's going to evaluate what you have and then what packages are supported for the version of Unity that you're currently using. We're going to go ahead and click on, you know, discover features. And then now this is going to give you everything that is available for MRTK. So normally for what we need today, we're going to be doing the Mixed Reality Toolkit examples because I want to run the hand interaction just like I showed you at the beginning of the video. Then I'm also going to be doing the Mixed Reality Toolkit extensions. And if you go down, I'm also going to be doing the standard assets. And I think that's everything. This one is going to be a dependencies of another one, so it'll automatically install. So if you go to get features, it's going to detect what we need. Okay, so now it has identified what we need, and these are the packages that we're going to be installing. And this is a dependency, just like I mentioned. We're going to go ahead and click on validate just to make sure that there's no issues with, you know, the version of Unity or packages, you know, type of conflicts that you may have. Click OK, import, and then we're just going to go ahead and hit approve. You can just look at all the different dependencies that we're going to have and then exit. And now Unity is going to basically resolve those packages and install them. Okay, once you have everything imported for MRTK, you're going to get kind of like a little dialogue that is going to walk you through what we need. You can just go ahead and hit next, and it's going to tell you a couple settings that we'll need to do. These ones I would apply, just go ahead and apply those, and then we can hit next. It's also going to tell you that it needs to import Text Mesh Pro. I would recommend that you do that because the scene that we need, it's going to require it. Okay, and then the other thing that it'll tell you is if you want to locate the examples. I'm just going to go ahead and always skip this step, and then we're going to do it a little different way. So if you go into Package Manager and we go into In Project, you're going to see that now we have these examples in here, and you can go in and be selective on what you want. The one that I want is going to be the demos hand tracking, so click on import into project. Once you do that, you can close out of the package manager, and we can clear the log so we don't see the ugly error in there. And then go into samples, and then 2.7.3, which is going to be the version that we're using. Then go into scenes. The one that I'm going to be opening is going to be the one that I always show up, which is the hand interaction examples, and then click on add to open scene. It's going to be the one that we're going to be building. So we're also going to need to install the Oculus integration, so I'm going to go into package manager and make sure that you change this to my assets, which is what I have selected, and then search for Oculus. Once you search for Oculus, you're going to see Oculus integration. Right now I have version 35, which is the latest, And I'm gonna click on import because I already downloaded it. Okay, so once we have the Oculus integration, it's really important that we go into the Mixed Reality Toolkit and then click on Utilities. And there's gonna be an option in here to integrate Oculus integration Unity modules. Make sure you click on that because that's going to be the glue between the Oculus integration and MRTK. The last thing that you need to do, because we're gonna be using the OpenXR backend, go into Oculus Tools OpenXR and then click on Switch to OVR plugin with OpenXR backend. Okay, so the next thing, go into the Oculus folder and we're going to click on Oculus project config, and we want to make sure that we enable the pass-through capability enable, and then we also want to make sure that we enable controllers and hands so that we can use also our hands and controllers for this experience. Okay, so now we're going to be focusing on MRTK. So if you go into the Mixed Reality Toolkit, you're going to see that we have a lot of different settings in here, and we could modify one of the default profiles, which we're going to be using the default Mixed Reality Toolkit configuration profile, and you can modify this one. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and clone it. This is going to be Oculus Mixed Reality Toolkit configuration profile and click on clone. And one of the things that we need to do in here, if we go into camera, and we also need to clone this camera. So we're going to do clone, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to keep it Oculus and then go ahead and click clone to clone it. And one of the most important things about this process is that we're going to change the clear flags to color. So let's go ahead and click on color. And then I'm also going to change the alpha value because this is going to be transparent. We want to be able to see through. Now, if we go into input, we're also going to be cloning the input. Let's go ahead and click on clone. Again, let's do the Oculus profile name, click on clone. And once you do that, we're going to be able to see that we have the input data providers. We should have a XR SDK Oculus device manager. So if you click on that and expand it, you're gonna see that this has basically a prefab that has the OVR camera. And if you remember the Oculus integration, that is going to be the camera rig. So we wanna be able to add the OVR pass-through layer to it so that we can enable pass-through. If you go into packages and we can expand some of these so we can see it. And you go into foundation, providers, and Oculus XR SDK, MRTK Quest, prefabs. You're gonna see that we have these ones in here. These are basically the ones that we're going to be using. So what I recommend that you do, and this is how I did it, I just right click in here and then show in Explorer. And what we'll do here, we'll go back and I'm gonna create a folder under assets, and then we'll just call it prefabs folder, and then just double click on it. And then we're gonna go ahead and get back into our folder, and I'm just gonna go ahead and drag and drop that into it. And once we do that, we should have the prefab and everything in here. We could click on open and it's going to take us to the actual variant of the prefab. So what I'm gonna do to be able to use pass-through is I'm gonna click on add component, and you can search for OVR pass-through layer. I already have it selected because I've been using it. And I'm also going to be changing this to underlay because we want all these 3D digital items to be on top, and then basically pass-through is going to be behind. I also need to change a couple of things in here. Well, the pass-through capability enable is already set because we set it on the scriptable object, but I'm also going to be enabling pass-through by clicking in here. And then if we go back and make sure that you go into the Mixed Reality Toolkit, we're going to be associating this with this one, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead and drag and drop that one. And if we click on it, make sure that everything is set correctly. We have our pass-through enabled here, enable pass-through. And then I also have underlay. Okay, so now that I have all that set up, I'm already wearing the Oculus Quest 2 and I'm gonna go ahead and deploy. So make sure you click on refresh and you can see your device. Let me try that one more time so we can see Oculus Quest 2. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do build and run and just give it a name. I'm just doing test.apk, hit save, and then I'm gonna deploy and test it out. All right guys, so I got it running. Let me go ahead and show you how this works. We can see my hands. I'm gonna be bringing in the menu just a little closer to me so we can see everything. Let me bring it up a little bit more so I can actually touch the piano. Piano works. We can do push different buttons. So everything is currently working fine. So if I wanted to grab the cup and bring it here, rotate it, try that. There we go. So we got full rotation. Let me grab that other object, bring it up, push it out. Then bring it down. So everything works. So if I wanted to interact with the menu here, I can bring it in hand close. This is a UI. So we can, you know, press different buttons, use the slider, move the different windows. If I wanted to move the window here, let me try. Oh, there we go. I have a really small office. So it's really hard to select different things. But if I want to bring this here and then basically scroll, that all works fine. So that's everything that I wanted to show you. I think the whole experience works just fine. So if you guys have any questions about this or you want to know more about MRTK, make sure you watch my videos on MRTK with HoloLens. And now you can use MRTK also with the Oculus Quest 2. Thank you very much, guys.